I have nothing left to bet, you idiot.
The plane.
That's rich.
Oh, why the hell not? I've got you beaten anyway.
Yeah.
What have you got? Wipe your mouth, Blackburn.
That wasn't supposed to happen.
But you know, I'll be taking that plane anyway.
What the bloody hell?
You lost, I beat you! Mm.
The thing is, Rackham, it's a very beautiful aeroplane, and you're kind of a jackass.
I beat you fair and square, goddammit! Stay the hell away from my kind!
Oh, you bastard! You can't do this to me, I beat you! I beat you!
My name's Clyde Blackburn. I'm a pilot and a gambler.
I'm George Rackham! I'm George bloody Rackham! Listen to me! You bastard, keep off my aeroplane!
If you asked me to name my biggest fault, I'd have to tell you. I'm just not a very honest person.
Welcome aboard! I'm Wilson, by the way. You must be George Rackham!
Sure, I'm Rackham. I'm your guy. Come on! Let's get this kite up in the air.
You're George Rackham, son of the 4th Earl of Windsor.
That's right. Hip, hip, go, babe.
The Bristol was everything it was advertised to be, a pure joy to fly. It was a crisp, sunny day, and everything would have been perfect had I only been alone.
Hey back there! It's a great day for a picnic, don't you think?
Right, you see that plane up ahead? You need to catch up with it!
Yeah, yeah! So listen! I know this little French place, maybe we pick up a couple of girls.
About girls, this is a test flight. You need to follow the route that plane is setting for you.
Okay, you're the boss, apparently.
Now let's get a feel for the yoke. Stay close on his tail.
that.
Easily, probably be speaking
wrench by the time we got to Jerry's beat.
I see.
You're a very suspicious man, Wilson. Has anyone ever told you that?
You okay?
Yeah, I'm
That's how we accidentally discovered where Germans were putting their munitions for half the western front. And since the pictures of HQ launched a major assault, there was a problem.
I'm not sure about this.
Come on!
We did a great deal to get close to this. We're never supposed to be there.
When the community sees these pictures,
we won't care.
We did a great deal.
We can do it again. I'm going to kill you. If we pile up on this, then you need to promise me that you'll get me back in one piece.
Sure.
Promise. I need your word.
Okay, I promise.
Stay here. And don't go into trouble.
You know, I did like it. But he was kind of naive.
So.
So they can blow that fortress all to hell. First, we'd have to down the barrage blips. Jesus, imagine being a lookout on a blimp. Next, we'd have to deal with their anti-aircraft troops. The assault was already in full swing when we got there. We'd have to deal with all those defenses, then escort bombers to their target when they arrived.
Make it to the fortress or
This mission is bust!
I know!
Bitch.
take care of you?
The bird was busted. She buried her nose in no man's land a half mile due west of where I went down. Wilson, the poor sap, didn't make it out. But that was his bad luck. I had more pressing problems.
Denkst du gerade?
Was?
I'm just gonna say I've had plenty of practice moving quietly. Out the back of bars, bedroom windows, you don't need the details. Anyway, Once those Germans were gone, I put my skills to work, heading west towards the British front, quiet as an alley cat. Between me and the British front were German trenches and German guns. Oh, and half the population of Berlin, all spoiling for a fight. Day. The Brits must have been sitting down for tea and crumpets instead of shelling the Germans. Still, I had to get through to our side of the line before those guns started up again. Those trenches were packed full of the Kaiser's finest, but hopefully, most of them would be looking for trouble coming the other way. Hopefully.
Yeah.
The dozen German machine guns at my back kinda encouraged me to keep my head down. No Man's Land was a maze of barbed wire, dead bodies, and debris. But I held my course. Did anything survive the crash that might be useful?
Your bleeding word. So either you're a decent bloke who's gonna help me, or you're a lying, no good bastard who look me in the eye and finish it. Come on! Which is it? Put your cards on the table, Blackburn. You're not George Rackham, are you? Son of the fourth bloody Earl of Windsor. How naive do you think I am? Oh.
Let's get out of here.
I was losing a lot of blood. I didn't have much time to get him back alive.
Look! He's moving into our lines!
The Germans aren't really known for giving up. They did everything they could to catch us. Wilson said I was a no-good, lying son of a bitch. I brought him home because I think he's probably right. And I hate that fact more than I can tell you.
Heard that man through No Man's Land? This guy's a bloody hero!
No, he's nothing of the sort. He's a cheat, a thief, and a liar. And he'll answer for his crimes.
That's right, Blackburn.
Off to the farm, are you?
I'm gonna speak up for you, you know, at the court martial. It might do you some good.
I doubt it, but thanks.
Wilson, with me. I need a gunner.
Over here. I'll do it. Rackham, let me help.
You don't deserve to fly.
Wilson, if I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die up there.
Come on, let's do this.
You sure you don't want to sit this one out?
Not a chance. You owe me a bloody medal.
Thank you.
this altitude!
Terminal on this damn balloon's gonna hear you.
Supporting us out three.
my story. A selfish man who risked his own life to save another, and in doing so, found he was saved himself. Things get mixed up in wartime, though, and you'll probably hear other versions. A rogue pilot who stole a plane, who killed his buddy, then lied, cheated, and murdered his way across half the Western Front, only to escape court-martial in the chaos of an air raid. But don't listen to any of that. What you heard from me is the truth. I wouldn't tell you if it wasn't. Would I?